Hey, my name is Matt Johnson, and if you are editing a video in DaVinci Resolve, you filmed with mixed frame rates, where some clips are at 24 FPS, some are at 30 FPS, 60 FPS, 120, etc., and you want to edit these clips quickly. Instead of bringing your clips one at a time down here to the timeline and then right-clicking on one of them and going to change clip speed and then changing the speed to 40%, hitting change, going through all the steps you have to take to make it slow motion, instead, I'm going to show you how you can easily make all of your clips slow motion in just a few clicks, which is going to save you a ton of time when editing. As a plus, I have great news. This tutorial is going to work for both the free and paid studio version of DaVinci Resolve. So regardless of which version of the program you're using, it's going to work for you. Also, this video does have a sponsor, and it's my friends at Track Club. If you're a filmmaker that's been looking for unique and creative songs that you can customize to perfectly fit your videos, you gotta check out Track Club. Now, what do I mean by customize? Well, here's where it gets really cool, because Track Club is the only music licensing site out there with a tool called MixLab that enables you to remix any song in their library, removing instruments, changing the volume, enabling you to get the exact sound that you need for your video. It's revolutionary. You can check out Track Club at the link in the video description. Now, the first thing that you're going to want to do is delete this old stuff that I already made, and we're going to delete this timeline because we need to create a new timeline. So we're going to do that by going up to File, New, Timeline, or you can press Control in on PC or Command in on Mac. And with this timeline, you're going to tell Resolve the frame rate that you want to use. So we're just calling this like frame rate demo. And then we're going to go over here to uncheck the project settings box, go over here to format, and here for frame rate, this is very important because I would recommend setting your timeline frame rate to 23.976 frames per second, also known as 24 FPS, because this is the most common frame rate in Hollywood, and it's really the minimum speed that you want your video to be playing back at. That said, though, if you want to edit and export your video at 30 frames per second because that's what the client wants, or that's how you need things to look for a video you're creating, that's fine. Just create a timeline with a frame rate of 29.97 FPS, which is also known as 30 FPS. Now, let's hit create. And with your timeline created, the next thing you're going to want to do is import all of your footage that you filmed. In this case, I have three clips that I filmed from a wedding, and it was a total mix of frame rates. If I go up here to details, you're going to see that some of these clips are at 24, one of them's at 29.97, 30, and another one is at 60 frames per second. We're all over the place. I didn't film anything at 120 or 240 FPS, but just know that what I'm going to be showing you works for any frame rate, including those higher frame rates. Now, that said, I do want you to notice that I do have a clip here that is at 24 frames per second as well. And this clip is not going to need to be made slow motion because it's already as slow as it can go at 24 FPS. But the great thing about this technique is that it's going to make all of your footage slow motion except for anything that is already 24 FPS. So you do not need to worry about separating out your 24 frames per second clips from your 30 or 60 FPS clips, etc. No, you can just throw them all into a bin whenever you import your footage. Next, it's time for the magic of this technique. Are you ready? Okay, we're going to go over here to the media pool. We're going to select all these clips. I'm going to select the first one, hold down shift, click to select all of them, or you can click and drag if you don't have your timeline here, but I'm just going to leave it there, so it's fine. If you don't have all your footage in one bin and you have it in different bins for, say, different cameras that you filmed in, that's fine. You can select all the footage in one bin, and once you do this technique, you can then select the footage in another bin, etc. It doesn't matter. Just know that you ideally want to apply this technique to all of your video clips that you've recorded. Next, with your video clips selected here, right-click on one of the video clips, go to Clip Attributes, and that's going to open up the Clip Attributes window, and here for Video Frame Rate, you're going to see that it says 23.976, even though the clips we selected are all different frame rates. Just know that it may say something different, but you've selected all your clips, so it's not going to be able to show you all the frame rates for all the clips. Regardless, you're going to want to select 23.976 if it isn't already selected, and then this is important, you're going to select this checkbox, which is going to enable Resolve to know, hey, you want all of these clips to be at this frame rate. Then we're going to click OK, and it looks like nothing changed. What the heck, Matt? Well, if we go over here, you're going to see that all of these clips' frame rates are now at 23.976. And then, whenever you click and drag all of these clips down to your timeline, you're going to see that all of them are now playing in slow motion, except for the one that's 24 FPS. So that one's 24 FPS. It's not going to do anything. But if we go over here to this shot, this was at 30, and it's just slightly slower, just a little bit slower. And then we go over here to this shot, and ooh, yeah, That's pretty slow-mo. Look at that. Got it going on. Mute that track. We don't need to hear that. But look at that. So smooth, so buttery in one click. This is one of the first steps that I take when editing any of my videos because it saves me the steps of making every single individual clip slow motion, and it is going to save you a ton of time when editing. That said, there is one caveat that I want you to be aware of when using this technique, and that is that whenever you make your footage slow motion in this way, Resolve can get a bit confused whenever it comes time for you to make proxies. So if you are someone that makes proxies, or if you are interested in making proxies, which will make the editing process in Resolve even smoother for you, I would highly recommend watching my proxies tutorial for DaVinci Resolve, which will explain this issue. I'll be releasing this proxy video very soon, and once it's out, I will link to it up in the corner and down in the video description, and that's going to be very helpful to you and help you edit as quickly as possible. Also, because I want to help you edit quickly, I've put together a course called Wedding Film Framework for DaVinci Resolve. This course is going to show you how to very quickly and easily edit wedding films in DaVinci Resolve. So if you're a wedding filmmaker and you've been considering learning Resolve, or maybe you already use Resolve, but you want to learn a faster way of doing things, I would highly recommend checking out the course. I will link to it down in the video description. In addition, I'm giving you more things for free. I will also link down in the description to my edit videos like a pro guide. This guide is going to show you some of the most important things that I have taken years to learn as a video editor, and like I said, it's completely free. You can check it out at the link down in the video description. Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe if you want to see more DaVinci Resolve tutorials in the future, and have a great day.